What's up guys, welcome back to the VG Shihai channel, and today I'll be doing my deck review on the new Bermuda Triangle deck. So I've seen that the Bermuda Triangle CVO7 has been released in Japanese and that it's going to be released in English very soon. So the cards in this set are actually really really strong and they can be dealt with a lot of clans, especially Chaos, because of the new G3 engine, and that's one of the main reasons why I actually decided to build a Bermuda Triangle deck, because of the new G3 engine. It just looks so nice, the artwork looks great. So I'm just gonna go through what I actually run in my deck, and maybe once the English release, you guys can maybe know how to build your decks and how it combos well with different types of cards. So for my deck, is mainly focusing primarily on Chouchou and Ange Hybrid. So mostly it will be Chouchou cards in the deck, followed by a bit of mixture with the new Great Tree Ange and the new Perfect Guard of Yonisei Kanzen, which is the Transcend Idol Aqua, which you can put 6 in the deck. And then the G-Zone I'll go through, as usual, is very standard. So let's moving on. We'll start with your starter. So this starter is actually pretty unique in the sense that it's actually quite a good starter. Name is Chouchou Emilia. So skill is Soul Blast 1. You may put a Chouchou Rear Guard at the bottom of the deck. At the end of this unit boost, you may pay the cost. If you do draw a card, then if you may put this unit into your soul. If you do, choose 3 of the units with Chouchou in your cards and you get power plus 5k until end of turn. So this is a really good card. It gives you soul and it gives your 3 of units plus 5k, but most importantly is that it sends your rear guard to the bottom. So let's just say you don't like your hand, or you know, you got too many triggers on your hand, you want to send some triggers back to your deck, you may, you know, call your triggers out and boost with this unit and send it back, so it costs soul plus 1. So this deck is very soul heavy in a sense, because I played the new Great Tree Ange, so it's very important that you not run out of soul. So I'll go through how this unit can combo with a Great 1 card later to get back your soul. At the same time, you may draw cards in the early game because this skill is not really restricted. Alright, so moving on, we have 6 of the new Perfect Guard. So this Perfect Guard is called Transcend Idol Aqua. So if you include 6 of this exact name cards called Transcend Idol Aqua in the deck, you may include up to 6, basically you may include up to 6. So you don't really have to play 6, you can play like 4 or 5, basically any number from 1 to 6. But obviously you play 6 because of the skill. And then the good thing about this Kanzen or Perfect Guard is that after you use, like, you know, to discard the cost for her skill, for the Sentinel skill, instead of putting the card you discard into the drop zone, you may, you put the card into the soul instead of discarding it. So yeah, so choose one unit, it can be hit at the end of battle. And then the second skill, which is actually quite useful too, other than, you know, putting the card in your soul, is that if you have 2 or more of her in the drop zone, and then, you know, you use the skill of Perfect Guard, you may choose all your rear guards, which ideally you want to, and then they cannot be hit until end of turn. So basically, they get the dismal skill somewhat, of they cannot be hit until end of turn. So it's really good if you don't have, like, any, if you don't want your rear guards to be retired off the field, because, you know, your rear guards reliant in some form of way because you have a triangle. So this is a really good card. Ideally, you can play you may also choose to play the Chouchou counter charging Perfect Guard, which is basically the one offer in the drop zone, and you discard her for the cost of you know, the Sentinel skill. You may construct one, which is fine also, it's not that bad, but I prefer to play Aqua for, you know, reasons. Moving on, we have 4 of this Chouchou rares. So her skill is pretty standard, as you can see there. It's just her name is Chouchou Sharia, if I'm not wrong, yeah. And then when this unit is placed from the red up circle to bottom of your deck, you may still charge one card, charge one. So this card is really good. You ideally want to play at least 3 or 4 of her, because you can combo with your starter. So basically what you want to do is you call her out behind your starter, you boost her, and then soul blast 1, you send this card to bottom of your deck, and then when you send it to bottom deck, you draw 1, and then you counter soul charge 1. So basically it's just the free of cost, because this starter needs soul blast 1, so it's basically free, and then at the same time you get to draw a card. So it's a really good combo you can pull off, especially for turns such as your Turia, your GR, which I'll go through later, where you need to send 3 red cards back to the bottom deck and extend your Vanguard again. So I really want to pick 3. Moving on, we have 3 of this new rescue Chouchou in unit. Skill is GB1. Choose one of the other red cards you chosen in this card and put it at the bottom of the deck. If you do, you may draw a card, and then GB2 skill during your turn. All your units you chosen their card names in your front row get power plus 2k. So it stacks. Ideally you want to play at least 3. I play obviously 3 in this deck. I might bump up to 4. I used to play 4, but then after that I realized that I had to cut down because I included one more of her inside. So her skill is really good if you need to send back your crit trigger, your triggers, or you want to send back a rear guard back to board deck. As I said, you can use her skill to send her back to board deck if you need any of the soul charge counter charge. So it's really good. I didn't want to play this 3, as I said. Alright, moving on to the grade 2. So this grade 2 lineup is a bit questionable, so do not judge me on it, so yeah. Alright, so first we have the new grade 2 card, which is, I forgot her name, I think it's, if I'm not wrong, it's Sandy, it should be Sandy, if I'm not wrong. So it's not Chouchou in name, as I said. So some cards in this deck are like a hybrid of Chouchou and not Chouchou. So some cards such as like Chansen Idol Aqua, like the style of the PG I showed you, is not a Chouchou in name. So yeah, and then her is not a Chouchou in name, as, and obviously the grade 3 that I'm gonna show you later, NG, is not a Chouchou in name too. So basically the skill is very simple. You can play up to 4 of her, but ideally you want to play at least 2 or 3 max. So I play 3 cost reasons, and then her skill is just basically she can be used to discard as a cost for calling out a G Guardian. So it's really good in BMT, which is Bermuda Triangle, where your deck is really defensive against some other decks, you can use her. It's really beneficial, because instead of having only 4 heal triggers, which you only can call out 4 G Guardians, you can now call out up to 7. If you play 4, it's up to 8. So yeah, and it's really good because it combines with some cards such as Ellie, which I'll go through later, which can use it multiple times. So moving on, we have the grade 2 Ranfa. So Ranfa is the new grade 2 rare, which is really good. Combust 1, soul blast 1, when your other rear guard is put into your deck, if you have Vanguard with Turian, it's cutting in bait, because you do stand this unit and it gets plus 5k at the end of turn. So usually this will be run 4 off in a typical Chouchou deck, but I run 3 of her even though I don't have the hard part of Chouchou, which is I have the Turian in, but the GR, which is I have Satura in me. I'll show you guys later the full name of the GR if I remember correctly. So basically when you strike into the GR, you ideally want to call her out, because she's a re-standing unit for Combust 1, Soul Blast 1, because it says that if you have Vanguard with Dura and card name, so it doesn't really say heart name, because your heart is usually my heart is usually NG. So yeah, moving on, you ideally want to just play 2 or 3 of her. If you're playing a full Chouchou deck, you might want to bump it up to 4 if you want. Alright, so I bought the trial deck for Chouchou specifically for her. So her name is Chouchou Ayane. You ideally want to play at least 2, but I want to play 3, but I don't want to buy another trial deck, because the trial deck only includes 2 of her, which is kind of stupid. But yeah, basically GB1, Compass 1, put this unit at the bottom of the deck. When your other rear guard with Chouchou and his card name is put to the deck, and you pay the cost. If you do draw a card, choose out one card with Chouchou and his card name from hand, call it to RC and you get plus 3k. So this card is really strong for consistent basis, as you want to keep attacking your opponent, especially when you strike into the GR. plus the GR skills, it's continuous, which I'll review later, as I said a lot of times. So all the cards in this deck actually support the GR in this set. So moving on, we have four of this new OP Great Two, in which I think she's one of the best Great Twos in the deck, because she's number one a Chouchou, and then number two is if you have a Chouchou Vanguard, this unit gets plus 2k, and then all your Chouchou units that are Great Two and above get continuous resist and boost. So basically what you can do is you can take a Great Three when you're, this is not Chouchou unit, so basically you can take a Great Three, any Great Three with Chouchou, they get resist. Grade 2 and above, they get resist, at the same time they get boost, so you can boost a unit in the front, so you don't ideally but you don't necessarily have to boost with a grade 1, you can boost with anything that's grade 2 or higher. So you can call Chouchou Rearguard to the back row also, and then boost along to hit with higher power. So this is a 4 off obviously, because it gives your Chouchou Rearguard's resist at the same time, so it's really, really beneficial. Alright, so now we're moving on to the Great Three. So the Great Trees, as I said, your hard card I always want to write into this is the Delight Genius Angie, the new Great Three. She looks so beautiful in this art form, I really love it. Skill, Soul Blast 1, when this unit is based on VC, Vanguard Circle, or when your Genie is striking, you play the cost. If you do, choose up to any two players' cards in any circle other than the Vanguard Circle and return them to hand. If the number of your opponent's cards return is 1 or more, you draw a card. If the number of return of your cards is 1 or more, you may search out your deck with 1 card regeneration breakthrough, reveal it, put it into your hand, and shuffle your deck. So this skill is very, very strong in a way that it's not limited to once per turn. So let's just say if your opponent gives you first strike, they write to grade 3, and then if they give you first strike, and your turn they give you first strike because you're at grade 2, you may write NG, so plus 1. Choose one of your units, return that back to your hand, and then choose one of your opponent's units and return back to your hand. Then you draw one card, search up your deck for one generation pick two at your hand, and then after you strike, let's just say you strike into the GR, you may use her skill again, so plus one. If you have another Rearguard, it's best to have another Rearguard. You may return it back to your hand, draw another card, and then search up your deck for another generation pick two, because you can bounce your opponent's Rearguard if they have another one to search up your deck for another generation breakthrough. So basically on your turn, before you even strike or use any skills, you may have up to 4 cards, additional cards in your hand, because you draw 2 when you bounce 2 of your Rearguards, and then you draw another 2 if you bounce if you bounce 2 of your enemy's Rearguards. So it's really good. If you bounce, so basically bounce, what I mean is return your Rearguards back to your hand. I use the keyword bounce because it's much easier. So basically if you return 2 or more cards from your circle, from your Rearguard circles to your hand, to back to you, you may search generation pick 2. If you return your opponents, you may draw a card. So this skill is one of the better skills, and this is why I say NG deck is so viable right now, and it's very counter heavy against Chaos because it bounces circles. It doesn't target the unit itself, it says circles, so you just return them back to hand. And then the last skill for the generation breakthrough is when you discard a card from hand as for the cost of strike, you may call it to Rearguard Circle instead. So instead of, you know, discarding a card for the cost of strike, let's just say you have no Great in your hand, you want to discard Great to a Great 1, you may call it out to RC instead, generation breakthrough. So you don't really have to waste any cards. That's why I say this skill is so good right now in the meta. So this card is a 4 off obviously, because I play it as a hard card. Moving on, we have 4 more great trees, in which I play 3 of the new Chouchou commons. So the new Chouchou commons is called Chouchou Burning. Skill is on Vanguard Circle, count plus 1, choose one of your Rearguards or a card from your hand and put it to the bottom of the deck. When doing this strike, you pay the cost. If you do, look at the top 2 cards from your deck, call up to 2 cards with Chouchou in the card names and shuffle your deck. So basically, this grants you more Rearguards if you don't have any at all on the field, because it ties up with your GR and other cards too. So it's really good if you want to fill up your board easily. but ideally you wouldn't want to ride her because I want to ride Angie. Second skill is when this unit is put to a deck from ours, very good circle, 2 more units and gets power plus 5k and the attack. So another reason why I play this great tree is because of the second skill, Generation Breakthrough. You may search her out using the skill of Angie if you don't have a strike. So what you want to do, ideally if you don't have a great tree, you ride into Angie, you Soul Blast, you bounce one of your cards, and you bounce one of your opponent's cards, you draw one, you search up your deck for one Generation Breakthrough, in which this card has Generation Breakthrough. You can search it out, add it to your hand, and then discard this card as a cost for strike. So it guarantees you that you may be able to strike if you don't have the Generation Breakthrough. And I mean, if you don't have a great tree, not if you don't have Generation Breakthrough. But if you do have the Generation Breakthrough, it's even better because you may then just call this card out to Rear Guard Circle, which is basically free. And last but not least, you play one of the Child Jack Chouchous. Basically, here she has two rare names, so you can play her if you want. Chouchou, her full name is Chouchou Debut Stage Kira. So skill is Combust 1, when your G unit strike, you pay the cost, you do reveal the top card of your deck, put into your hand, and that card is a Chouchou, and cut in, choose one of the rear guards, put it at the bottom of your deck. You put a card at the bottom of your deck, you may draw a card. And then Generation Break 1, you may strike for free during your red phase. If your rear guards is less 1 or less, you may strike for free. So this is good, a good card against decks that retire rear guards on a consistent basis, maybe such deck as Kagero or, you know, Chaos. When they lock your cards, then you have less or one rear guard, may just ride into her and strike. But ideally you wouldn't want to, because, you know, as I said, my right target is still NG. Alright, now moving on to the triggers. So triggers, very standard, I play 12 crits, no question. Do not run stands, do not run draws, do not run anything else, just run crits. Alright, so for the crits, we play 4 of the Chouchou crits, Chouchou Sarah, that's the name, Chouchou Sarah. So GB1, Combust 1, put this unit in the soul, at the end of a battle that are Vanguard with Chouchou's card name attack, you pay the cost, you do draw a card, choose one card from your hand called Chouchou, and then call it to Red Dark Circle, and it gets power plus 5k. So this is really good when you combine with other cards, like your GR, as I said, which I'll be reviewing later. It combos with a lot of other cards too, so this is a definitely a fall off, because at the same time it's a crit. So this deck doesn't really use up much counter blast, as you can see of a lot of my rear guards. It's not really counter blast heavy, so even if you want the counter charging engine, you may just use the great one, as I said. You just use a great one, you send back construction switch, or you can just use the crit, which I am playing, and it's Chouchou in name too. So basically, just move this crit into your soul and you counter charge one. So you play 4 of that, very standard. If you just need that counter charging, and in which you rarely don't need it because this deck is not counter blast heavy. And then last but not least, we have the new strong crit. So the crit is pretty standard. When this is based on Rear Guard Circle, not really when this is based, when it's on a Rear Guard Circle, GB2, Combust 1, when this unit boosts, you may bounce this unit back from your Rear Guard Circle back to hand. So basically you return this unit back from the Rear Guard Circle back to your hand. You double the boosted unit's power, and then if the boosted unit has a Generation Breakthrough, it gets plus 1 crit. So this is the new trigger where they come up with a zero power, because basically when this boost, Combust 1 double the boosted attack's power, and then yeah, Generation Breakthrough, it crit plus 1, and this unit defends your hand. So it's really good. Ideally you run around 4, as I said, you run 12 crits in this deck, so why not? And it uses 1 Combust, but yeah, as I said, this deck is not really Combust heavy, so what, just why not? And then obviously you run 4 of the new heals. Basically it's the same as every other 10. If you have one in drop zone, you discard one more, you may buy two to either counter charge one or so charge one. So as you can see, this deck is actually quite consistent. That's all for the main deck. You have the soul charge power, you have the counter charging power. Counter charging, soul charging, you can use the heal trigger, you can use this, you can use the great one, as I said right here. You can use the great one, you can use your Kanzen to soul charge, you can use your starter, worst come to worst, you just shove into your soul for one soul. Yeah, for one soul basically. So it's such a consistent deck. Alright, moving on, we have the G-Zone. So I would like you guys not to judge my G-Zone, especially when you see I play 5 G-Guardians and 4 of the G-Guardians are her, exactly. So I'll explain the skills, moving on to all the cards right here. So 16 G-Zones. So first we'll go through the G-Guardians. Alright, so the G-Guardians, you might want to play maximum... I'm not too sure about this, so you guys can tell me about it in the internet. But I'm not too sure how does this skill works exactly, because I see some people only play one of her. But the skill is, for each face-up guardian or sentinel in the G-Zone, or in the drop zone, of Luxury Wave Ally, which is this card's name, this unit plus 10k shield, and then Generation Breakthrough, when this unit returns back from returns back to the G-Zone, so plus 1, you may flip her face down. So I don't understand why people only run 1, because you need, for each face out of her, you will get plus 10k shield. So I run 4 in that, because if you have 3 of her face up, you G-Guardian another time, it's actually a 45k shield, because it's plus 10, 20, 30. Then it's plus 15 right here, so it's a 45k shield. And then when she returns to the G-Zone, you may soak up some flip her face down. So I'm not too sure, and at the same time, you are unable to use more than 3 G-Guardians because of the rulings. If you use more than 3 G-Guardians, you are unable to use any more G-Guardians. So there's no point of playing her actually. So ideally, she's the new Chouchou G-Guardian, which in which when this unit is based on Rearguard Guardian Circle, choose one of your Chouchou Rearguards, send it to bottom deck, and then you count charge one, and this unit plus 10k shield. So you don't really need to play her. Ideally, you want to switch her out with Sandy. So the old G-Guardian, SC G-Guardian, if I'm not wrong, please switch it out with her. So when you G-Guard with Sandy, you must flip one of the G-Guns up, so you flip Luxury with Ellie up. Sandy's skill is, for each 2 cards in your hand, for each 2 cards in your hand, this unit's shield plus 5k, and at the same time, you may count plus 1, and this unit plus an additional 5k. So it's really good, because in this deck, your hand size will be very consistent, and you have 7 G-Guardians, 4 heal triggers, including 3 of the Sandy's, as I said in the deck. It has the exact same name. So ideally, you want to switch this unit out for the Sandy, FC Sandy, but for me, you know, I'm a poor boy, I can't really afford the Sandy, and it's super hard to find. So yeah, that's the G-Guardians. I know it's a bit weird in my deck, like I play 5 G-Guardians and 4 of them are exact same G-Guardians, but yeah. Please advise me, internet, if you know what's going on, how to use the G-Guardians. So yeah, okay, moving on, we have one Sabreeze. So Sabreeze is very highly optional in this deck. You don't really have to play it, but since I have 16 slots, I mean, I have an additional slot in my G-deck, so why not? And then this is highly optional too. So what I want to say is that I've bought one of the booster box of this set, which is CBO7. I didn't expect it, but I just bought one box, I opened it, and inside lay this beauty, goddess of Megiddo. So Bushiroad, if you don't know, Bushiroad printed Megiddo in an alternate form, in the form of Bermuda Triangle. So, you know, cause waifu, whatever reason. So basically it looks really nice if you include her in the deck. You don't necessarily have to, because it's actually pretty bad. Megiddo is not really a good Zero Dragon unless it's really useful, such as in decks such as Aquaforce. I think it's the best in Aquaforce. It's great in Grand Blue, it's great in Bermuda, but I think it really shines in Aquaforce when the Rearguards can switch places and attack each other and stand again. So moving on, we have 2 of the NGs. The old, not new, CBO5GR. So ideally you want to play at least one or two of her to counter decks such as Chaos, or you just want to farm the hand size. So I got one of the normal GR right here and one of the SP ones, so the SP looks really nice. So count pass 2, choose a face down card from the G zone and bring face up. Then choose any amount of circles. Take note that it's circles, so you don't really have to choose your units. So you can bounce lock cards, you can bounce anything basically. You can bounce resist units also. So choose any amount of circles, you may return that back to your owner's hand, and then this unit plus 5k for each card that was bounced. And then if you bounce 5 or more cards, you may draw 1. If you bounce 7 or more cards, this unit plus 1 drive. So basically, you ideally want to bounce more than 7, at least 7, so they can get that draw card and then quad drive at the same time. And your opponent would no chance have to perfect guard or come in with that because it's gonna be freaking big. And if you, as a Bermuda Triangle player that runs 12 crits in the deck, it's pretty scary if you just let the deck hit like this. Alright, so moving on, we have GB8. So it's really not necessary to play the GB8 in this deck, but I happen to have it because a friend kinda gave it to me, so I might as well just run in the deck. So the skill of the GB8 is basically choose one of the cards from a hand and discard it if I'm not wrong. And then when after this unit is attacked, you may return all your rear guards from the field back to your hand, and then superior call up to 5 of them back onto the rear guard circle, and they all plus 5k. So basically it's a weaker version of Magiro, but yeah, you don't get to switch places if I'm not wrong. So yep. Moving on, we have Laquina. So correct me if I'm wrong, I'm so sorry if I get the skill wrong. I'm totally forgot about her skill. So if I'm not gonna combust one, flip herself face up. And then you may put any amount of rear guards from your rear guard circle back to the bottom of your deck, and then draw the same number of cards that you put. And then if you have a Chocho heart, in which most of the time you don't have because I run Angie, but if you if you run like, you know, a full Chocho deck, or if I ride into any of the Chocho's victories, if you have a Chocho heart, you may draw a card. And then if you return 4 or more rear guards back to the bottom of the deck, you may choose up to 5 cards from your hand and superior call it to rear guard support. So basically it's a multi-attacker. You will likely use her in the late game, or you can use her as first strike too if you want, if your hand's pretty bad. You just wanna, you know, filter your deck by putting all your triggers from your hand back to the deck. Then you just draw more cards. So it's pretty necessary that you ideally want to play at least 2. And then one of the new Chocho rares, it's pretty meh, I would say. It can be a first strike if you want, but I would not prefer X skill, because it's X skill, it's not on attack skill. But yeah, it's okay, because so plus 1, choose up to 5, choose not up to, but choose 5 of your rear guards, Chocho rear guards, make sure that it is Chocho rear guards, and put it at the bottom of the deck. If you do, draw 3 cards, and this unit plus 20k 1 crit. So yeah, that's basically it. It's a rare, and that's the skill, so I think it's pretty meh. Maybe you can lose it at a late game, so as you're not decked out at the same time. If your opponent has used up all their Kanzen or perfect guards, you ideally can strike into her for that, you know, crit and plus 20 cases, what, 46k attacker. So yeah, it's pretty okay. And last but not least, as I said, we've mentioned the new Chocho GR. So this, I'm not too sure about the name of the GR, so, oh, okay, if I remember correctly, it's Chocho Popular Favor Turia. Yeah, so it has a Chocho in name, and then it has Turia in name to combo with the Great 2 after, when, you know, you can stand the Great 2 again. So, Kamba San, Sopa San, stand this Great 2, and then it plus 5k. So, the OP skill of this Turia is that the first skill is not GB restricted, so basically act once per turn. Choose a face down card from G-Zone and turn face up. So, ideally, you wanna turn Luxury with Ellie face up so that you can get the extra shield if you actually G-Guard the next turn. So choose face down card and turn face up. This unit gets continuous. Make sure, remember that it's continuous. Vanguard circle, all your units with Chocho and the card names in the front row get plus 5k for each of your open rear guard circle. So this skill is just amazingly overpowered and strong in a way, because it will combo with cards such as the crit trigger, as I said, like here. So I'm just going to show you an example of what typical Chouchou stripe would look like. So okay, maybe this and this maybe, and then you have Chouchou this way. Okay, so basically you have this is your field, and then okay, this is really necessary. So you choose a face down G-Guardian, turn the face up, you flip up luxury athlete, and then your whole front row plus 5k because it has one open mega circle right here. So remember, these units gets all your grade 2 and above units get resistance boost. So first you want to attack with this unit. So when this crit boost, count plus 1, which is like an example, you bounce this back to your hand, so it's gone. You double this unit's attacking power. So remember that this is continuous. So 11 plus 5, because there's one open leg up circle before. So it's 16 times 2, which is 32. And at the same time, when you bounce this card back to your hand, it plus an additional 5k. So 32 plus 5 is 37. And since this card has the generation break 2, it plus 1 crit. So it's basically 37,000 power hitting your opponent at 11k power, in which your opponent has to guard 30k unless they want to take 2 crits into the face. So it's very strong. You can use it to, you know, whack out to basically ruin your opponent's day or whatever. But ideally you want to call full field because you need to send back 3 of your rear guards for her second skill. So her second skill for Chouchou favorite Tira is GB3. At the end of this unit attack, you choose up to 3 of your rear guards and put them in the bottom of the deck in any order. Each guards will put standing unit and minus 2 drive. So basically it's a restanding vanguard. And take note that this is all for all arch types, but only the first skill is restricted to Chouchou in the rear guard with Chouchou in the heart in the front row that gains 5k. But the second skill is just choose any 3 rear guards and just put it at the bottom of the deck in any order and standing unit drive minus 2. It's really good, especially if I play a Chouchou hybrid with Ange, because most of my rear guards will be Chouchou in game, so it doesn't really matter, my whole front row will get plus 5k. So the gist of this is, let's just see, you have 5 rear guards in play, you attack this, count plus 1, send this back, so it's just basically 11 times 2, 22, 22 plus 1, 5k open rear guard, so it's 27. Remember this is continuous, so it still gets the plus 5k for each open rear guard circle. So it's 27k, so let's just say opponent guards 20 is fine. So you boost with Ranfa, I mean not Ranfa, you boost because you know all your grade 2 and above Chouchou units get gain resist and boost, so you can boost from behind. So basically 19, 9 plus 11, so it's 20. 20 plus 1 open rear guard circle, so it's 25k. Open guards 15, that's fine. So boost with Vanguard, so 26 plus 5 plus 5, so it's 36k to your opponent's face. Let's just say your opponent sticks it, whatever, typical drive. Then you bought that 3 of your rear guard, so let's just say you bought that 3 of this, because you wanna stand your run fire right here, so bought that, go to the bottom of the deck. So you run to the bottom of the deck. And then you combat on so bad. Then this unit will stand at the same time too, so it's really good. I feel that this deck is one of the best decks currently now in the meta because of just this OP card, and ideally you wanna display 2 or in this case I run 3 because your first strike can be her because this skill is not GB restricted at all, it's super strong. And then if you give your opponent first strike, it doesn't matter because you have 7 G-Guard and you can just G-Guard anytime you want. So yeah, this deck is pretty good at the moment. Unfortunately, it soon will be, you know, outcasted because the reboots and all that. So yeah, I'll probably make a new video about that. But yeah, thank you very much for watching, guys. I hope you guys liked my Chouchou / Ange Hybrid deck review on the new Bermuda Triangle support. So thank you very much for watching. Like, comment, subscribe. This is VD Shihai, and I am out. Peace.